Now, first of all, what is the basis period and why we use this basis period concept? Normally, it happens that when a sole trader or a partnership business prepare its set of accounts, so normally it happens that the accounting year end is different from the tax year. And we know that for an individual business, the tax year starts from 6th April to following 5th April. So for example, if any business is preparing accounting year end for the, suppose, profit for the year 31st December 2021. Now, the profit is for the year December 2021, but the tax year is different. An accounting year is from January to December, but tax year is from 6th April to 5th April. So how profit of a particular accounting year is to be taxed in the relevant tax year? For this purpose, we used to learn this concept that is called basis period. Now, this basis period rule is applicable in three situations for both sole trader business as well as for a partnership business. But this is not applicable for a company. There is no concept called basis period in company. So for a sole trader or a partnership, we can classify our business into three stages. One is an ongoing business that has started a few years ago. The second one is the start of a business that is called commencement of business. And third one is when there is a closure of business that is called cessation of business. So you might ask to calculate the relevant basis period for either the ongoing business, for commencement of business, or for cessation of business. So you should know the rule that in case of ongoing business, in case of commencement, in case of cessation, how accounting period is related with the tax year. Same is also applicable for the start of partnership business, the end of partnership business, and as well as the admission of partner. When you are admitting a new partner into an existing partnership business, and when you are terminating an existing partner, that is retirement of partner. So that's why this topic is very important, because it is applicable on both sole trader as well as the partnership business. Now you should know that for each stage of business, what is the rule of identifying a relevant tax year for the particular accounting profit? So let's recall the rule. If there is an ongoing business, and a business is preparing a set of accounts, suppose, for the year ended 31st October 2021. Business is preparing its accounts for each year for the year end 31st October. And there is a profit of, suppose, 50,000. Now, as this is an ongoing business year end, so the relevant tax year for an ongoing business is we have to identify its current year basis. So what is the rule for ongoing business? We have to identify the current year basis for an ongoing business. And how you can identify current year basis? Just check its year end date and check in which tax year this 31st October 2021 falls. So for the relevant tax year for this 31st October 2021 is 2021 and 2022, that is 21 22, tax year 21-22. So 50,000 profit is to be taxed in the year 21-22. So for an ongoing business, the rule is quite simple. You have to just identify the current year basis. And what it means, find out that in which tax year this year end date falls. But when we move to the commencement of business, the rules becomes complicated. So let's discuss the commencement of business scenario. So for example, a sole trader is commencing his business, say suppose from 1st November 2021, and he or she has decided to prepare his first set of accounts to either to 12 months, less than 12 months or more than 12 months. So there will be a special scenario for basis period, and we need to understand that particular scenario for commencement of business. So in case of commencement of business, the first tax year will always be from the commencement date to following 5th April. So whatever is the commencement date, my first tax year would be from the commencement date till the following 5th April. For example, if my commencement date is 1st November 2021, so my first tax year accordingly will be 1st November 2021 to 5th April 2022. And how many months the tax authority will assess is November, December, and till March. So it's 5 month period. And relevant tax year would be 21-22. So whatever is the profit, we have to pay tax on 5 months profit. Similarly, if your business starts from 1st July, so you have to calculate from 1st July to the following 5th April. And this is fixed for every kind of business which has just started from the commencement date to following 5th April. But as far as the second tax year is concerned, when you try to find out the second tax year, then what would be the second tax year? It depends on what is your accounting profit duration. For example, you might have a accounting year less than 12 months. There would be different scenario. You might have greater than 12 months. And you might have a standard 12 month accounting period. So in the second tax year, my date of basis period or the tax year will depend on what's your accounting year end. If it is less than 12 months, a separate rule will be applicable. If it is more than 12 months, there will be a separate tax rule for this particular basis period. So let's assume that after identifying the first tax year, that is from the commencement date to following 5th April, we need to identify the second tax year, and let's assume that the accounting period is less than 12 months. So for a scenario where accounting year is less than 12 months, what would be the rule? So first tax year rule will remain the same. That is from the commencement date to following 5th April. But for the second tax year, you have to start your second tax year again from the commencement date. But if you start again from the commencement date to following 12 months. But if you start again from the commencement date, there will be a problem that you have to pay tax twice. And this will create a problem of overlapping of profit. Overlap profit means that you have paid tax in first year, some of the tax as well as in the second tax year. So if you have designed your accounting date in such a way that it is less than 12 months, then there will be an overlapping of profit. And as a result, you have to wait for the refund of that particular excess tax being paid to the tax authority. But remember the rule, the second tax year in case of less than 12 months will always start from commencement date, and it will be 12 months from commencement to following 12 months. Let me give you an example. For example, Mr. X started a sole trader business on, suppose, 1st July 2020. Accounting year will be suppose 30th April each year, and first accounting year is 30th April 2021 and we have a profit of 75,000. And next accounting year is 30th April 2022 and we have a profit of 85,000. As this is a case of a commencement of business, so we need to identify first two tax years. Identify first two tax years and overlap profit in between. In these two tax year, if there is any overlap profit. Now see, check the scenario. This is a case of commencement of business. The commencement date is 1st July 2020. The accounting year end is 30th April. Now, first of all, you have to identify whether it is a case of 12 month, less than 12 month or more than 12 month. So from 1st July 2020 to 30th April, it means July, August, September, October, November, December. We have, let me just change a bit from this date in order to make it a less than case that starts from 1st August 2020. So from 1st August 2020 to 30th April, it's August, September, October, November, December. Jan, Feb, March, April. So it's a scenario of August, September, October, November, December, 5 months, and Jan, Feb, March, April. So it's a 9 month business profit. 75,000. Now we have to identify the relevant tax year. So what we do, we'll follow the rule. And what is the rule? If the accounting period is of less than 12 months, then first tax year is from the commencement date to following 5th April. And then the subsequent tax year will always be from the commencement date again till the 12 month. So let's prepare the relevant dates. So first tax year, date will be from commencement to 5th April. And what is the commencement date? It's 1st August 2020. So from 1st August 2020 to the next 5th April 2021. If we count this date, so we have August, September, October, November, December, Jan, Feb, March. So we have to consider 8 month profit in the first tax year and the date of first tax year, and the date first tax year would be 2021. And how much profit is to be assessed in 2021 is 75,000 multiplied by 8, and the profit was of 9 months. So we have to consider 8 months profit in the first tax year, which is 2021. If you calculate this, so how much is the profit? 75,000 divided by 9 multiplied by 8. So it's 66,667. Assessable profit in 2021 is 66,667. You have to pay tax on 66,667 in the tax year 2021. Now the next tax year again will start from commencement. And why from commencement? Because it is a case of a less than 12 month period. So as per the tax rule, we have to start again from commencement to following 12 months. And as a result, my starting date is again 1st August 2020. And if you go along the 12 months date, that would be 31st July 2021. And what would be the tax year? 31st July 2021 means it's 21-22. And now I have to consider the whole 12 months profit I have to identify. So from 1st August to 31st July, if you can see, 75,000 is from 1st August to 30th April, the whole 9 months profit. And the 3 months profit will be taken from the next period, that is 85,000. So it's 85,000 multiplied by 3 by 12. This is 9 months and this is 3 months, making it to 12 month profit. And that would be 85,000 over 12 into 3 plus 75,000. So we have to pay tax in the next year, that is 96,250, on the profit of 96,250. The second tax year, in any case, in any scenario, in any situation, the second tax year will always be of 12 months. The first tax year might be 12 months. It might be less than 12 months. It might be more than 12 months. But a second tax year can never be less than or more than 12 months. It will be always 12 month period. Now, if you compare the first two tax year, you can see that there is a duplication of the date. There is a duplication of profit. So you can see clearly here, the 75,000 into 8 by 9, 8 month profit is taxed in 2021. And the same 8 months profit is included in this 75,000. So there is a duplication of profit in both 2021 as well as in 21-22. And this is duplication between first year and second year. There might be a duplication in second and third tax year as well. But right now I'm focusing on first two tax year. So on the basis of first two tax year, what is the overlap profit in first two tax year? The overlap profit is 75,000 into 8 by 9, and that is 66,667. This whole profit is taxed twice. And the date of overlapping is 1st August 2020 to 5th April. Examiner can ask you about the date, about the amount as well. So whenever there is a case of commencement of business and there is a accounting year which is less than 12 months, there will be a duplication in first and second year, as well as some duplication in second and third year as well. So it is not beneficial for a business to prepare an accounting period which is different from the tax year date and a less than 12 month case. The detailed rules or the detailed calculation you can see in my regular lectures. So I'm just moving to the another part, which is the commencement of business, and the scenario is the accounting period is of 12 months. So if your accounting period is 12 months exactly, so then how you can identify the overlap profit and what is the tax rule? The first tax year will remain the same. The first tax year rule will always remain the same. That is, we'll start from the commencement date to 5th April. But as far as the second tax year is concerned, it's 12 months to accounting year end, which means the same, that is from commencement to 12 months. It means the basis period rule for a tax year or for an accounting year, which is less than 12 months, or a 12 month accounting year, the basis period rule will remain the same. So let's identify one example in this scenario. For example, a sole trader started his business from 1st July 20, preparing accounts to 30th June each year. So first period profit is 88,000 and the subsequent accounting year is 30th June 22. And profit is 45,000. Identify first two tax years and overlap profit, if any. Our objective is to set an accounting year end in such a way that we will minimize the overlap profit. And if you want to avoid overlap profit, the best way is to set the accounting year end as per the tax date, that is 5th April. But it's usually not possible because accounting rules and regulations are quite different from the tax rules and regulation, and the circumstances usually do not allow you to choose the same date. But again, in the exam, the examiner might ask you about how to minimize the overlap profit. So you have to choose the date accordingly, which will minimize the overlap profit. Now, in this scenario, first of all, check what is the accounting year end. The commencement is 1st July. The year end is June. So if you count 1st July to 30th June, this is a case of a 12-month accounting period. Now, let's start the basis period rule. The first tax year is always the same, and that is from the commencement to 5th April. And in this question, this date is 1st July 2022. The next 5th April will be 2021. And as a result, for how many months profit is to be taxed? So from July, August, September, October, November, December, Jan, Feb, March. So we have 9 months profit we have to assess. So 88,000 is of 12 month, and we have to pay tax on how month, how much? That is 9/12 from July to 5th April. So as a result, the amount would be 88,000 divided by 12 into 9, and that is 66,000. You have to pay tax on 66,000 profit. In the tax year, what would be the tax year? The tax year would be 2021. Now my next tax year would be 21-22. And the date will be the same. We'll start from where? 1st July 20. commencement to following 30th, following 12 months, that is 30th June 21. And as a result, the complete 12 months profit, which is 88,000, is to be taxed in the next tax year, which is 21-22. Now, let's identify the overlapping. Is there any overlapping? You can see. Is there any duplication? So you can see that 1st July 20, in the next is 1st July 20. So there is a duplication. Exactly the first part, that is 66,000, is duplicated. So this is overlap profit. And the whole first tax year is duplicated. That is 66,000. And the date is from 1st July 20 to 5th April 2021. But in the case of a 12 month period, surprisingly, there will be no further overlapping in the subsequent period. But in the case of less than 12 months, there will be more overlapping in the subsequent period. So it is better to have a 12 month accounting period rather than a less than 12 month accounting period in order to minimize your overlapping profit. Now, the third scenario that we have to consider is where accounting year end is reflecting more than 12 months. Our first tax year again will remain the same. That is, it is always the same, which is commencement to 5th April. Now, important thing is, what would be my second tax year? Now, instead of starting from the commencement date to following date, we have to start from year end, identify the year end, and then go back 12 months. So we can also say that 12 month to year end. Or we can say that from year end, you have to go back 12 months. So instead of commencement to 12 month, we'll identify our year end date and we'll go back to 12 month. There will be overlapping in this situation. Let's see how much and how we can identify the overlap profit. But just know the rules of overlapping. So for example, commencement date is, suppose it's 1st October 2019, and I'm preparing my accounts. So accounting year end is, let's see, it's 31st December each year. And the first accounting year is 31st December 2020. And I have a profit of, suppose, 58,000. So the subsequent dates will be 31st December each year, and there is a profit of 65,000. Now see, this is a scenario of more than 12 months. My commencement date is 1st October 19, and my year end is December 20. So if you count October, November, December, 3 months, and then the subsequent 12 months. So it is a scenario of a 15 month accounting period. So now let's follow the tax rules. So the first tax year will be from the commencement date, that is 1st October 2019, to following 5th April, it will remain the same. That is 2020. So as a result, October, November, December, Jan, Feb, March, I have to consider 6 month profit, 58,000 into six out of 15 months. Let me count it again. October, November, December, 2019. And then till 2020, it's 15 months profit. So 15 months and into six. So we have to pay tax on 23,200 only. In the tax year would be 1920. This is first year. And the next tax year, we have to create the next tax year is 2021. So it will be the next tax year. We have to start from the ending date. Look here, ending date is 31st December 2020. And we have to go back to 12 months. So it means it will start from 1st January 2020. Now cross check from 1st January 2020 to 31st December, it is a 12 month period. Now, rather starting from the commencement, that is 1st October 2019, I have started from year end to 12 months. So I have to consider 12 months profit. Again, 58,000 multiply by 12 out of 15. Now there is a duplication. 58 divided by 15 into 12, and that is 46,400. So 46,400 is a profit which is to be taxed in tax year 2021. Now, can you find out the duplication in first two tax year? So there is a duplication. You can see duplication. And if you have to identify the duplication easily, just see. 1st October 19 is not there in second date. So there is a duplication. You can clearly identify the duplication. So just see this date. From 1st January to 5th April. This 1st January to 5th April is common in these two dates. So Jan, Feb, and March. 3 month duplication is there. So overlap will be 58,000 into 3 by 15. And that is into 3. And that is 11,600. And what is the overlapping date is 1st January 20 to 5th April 20. This is the overlapping date. So I have discussed up till now, it's how to handle the ongoing business, how to handle the commencement of business, that is the less than 12 month case, standard 12 month case, and more than 12 month case. The detailed rules, you have to refer to my recorded lectures for the detailed rule, for the detailed practice, and same rules are applicable for partnership business. Commencement of partnership, same rule. Admission of a new partner, same rule. So whether it's a scenario of sole trader or partnership, these rules are also applicable on this situation. Now let's talk about that. Sometime it happens that a business wants to change its accounting date. Now, what would be a suitable accounting date if you are changing our accounting date? So will that be beneficial? Will that release some overlapping of profit? Will that create some further overlapping of profit. So we have to choose the date wisely. But before discussing about the change of accounting date, we have to discuss that whether a change of accounting date is permitted by tax authority or not. So let's refer to my notes with respect to the change of accounting date. You can find the details in the notes about the conditions and the timing about change of accounting date. Look, the condition. First of all, you should know the condition. And a very important thing is, you should know that you have to inform HMRC about the change of accounting date. You should know the relevant date till you have to inform. So an individual must meet certain conditions in order to qualify to change an accounting date. It means a business cannot change the date until and unless the condition is satisfied. First of all, the change of accounting date must be notified to HMRC by the 31st January following the tax year in which the change was made. So if you are changing in, suppose, 1920, the tax year in which you have changed the date, then the date of 1920 is, suppose the date is 6th April 19 to 5th April 20. So after this 5th April, the following 31st January, you have to inform the tax authority following 31st January 21. And second thing is that the first accounts to the new accounting date must not exceed 18 months in length. Means your new date will be 18 months or less than that. It cannot exceed 18 months. So either you can create the next date, which is less than 12 months, which is 12 months, and which is more than 12 months, but it cannot exceed 18 months. And the third one is, a change of accounting date must not have occurred within the previous 5 years. So there is a condition that if once you have changed the accounting date, in the next 5 years, there will be no change of accounting date unless there are situation where tax authority allows you to do that. So this is the condition. Now, if you want to change your accounting date, so you have to carefully choose the new accounting date because it will affect the level of profit to be taxed in that tax year. It will affect the overlapping of profit. It will either create some overlapping of profit or it will release some of the existing overlapping of profit. And it also affects the timing and amount of tax payment. Means either you have to pay your tax payment early or you have to pay your tax payment late. Now, examiner might ask about that, what is the better way, whether you have to change your accounting date just after the tax year or just before the tax year? So you have to consider the scenario that what is the benefit of just after 5th April or just before 5th April. See, if you are planning to change your accounting date just after 5th April, that means just after the tax year. That is, for example, you're planning to change your accounting date to 30th April. For example, previously your accounting year end was 31st October 2020. And now you are planning to change it to 30th April. So what would be the benefit then? What would be the consequence? In that particular scenario, there will be maximum interval between earning profit and payment. It means that the difference between earning profit and the tax payment date, there is a huge gap. and there will be advantage of getting some time for payment. As there will be a time between earning profit and payment, so it means you will have enough opportunity to plan that how you can be benefited from this particular date. But as a result, if you choose the date after 5th April, there will be higher overlapping of profit. So from the perspective of overlapping of profit, this is not advisable to have a date after 5th April. But if you choose to have a date just before 5th April, that means suppose 31st March or 28th of Feb. So it means that you have a shortest interval between earning of profit and payment. Because suppose your date is 31st March, then you have to pay tax very soon against that. So there is a shortest interval between earning profit and payment of tax. And there will be a shortest interval for your tax planning opportunity. You have less time for tax planning. But if the date is exact 31st March, there will be no overlapping of profit, or there will be a minimum overlapping of profit. In the past papers, examiner has asked this situation that the business want either a date after 5th April or before 5th April to advise that what would be the overlapping in both situations. So advantages of tax year ending on 5th April, advantages of tax year before, you have to assess from the date. Now let's discuss a past paper question in order to have a better understanding of the scenario. So this is an extract of a past paper question in which this particular topic was tested. There are three part question. First part says that on the assumption that P changes his accounting date to 20th Feb, state the date by which he should notify HM Revenue and Custom of the change and calculate the taxable trading profit for each of the tax year 21, 22 and 22, 23. In the second part, on the assumption that P changes his accounting date to 30th April. Now the first part says that before 5th April, this is a scenario of before 5th April, and this is a scenario of after 5th April. What would be the basis period for 21, 22 and 22, 23? And what would be the effect on overlapping profit? And then in the third requirement, identify and explain two advantages of using a year end of 30th April rather than 28th Feb. That is after 5th April, what are the two advantages? We have already discussed that there will be a time lag. There will be a more time available for tax planning. There will be an advantage for that. So let's see the question. Mr. P began trading as an unincorporated sole trader on 1st January 2014. The business was started in January 2014. Has always prepaid accounts to 31st October. So the first year was from 1st January to 31st October and then 31st October each year. Has overlap profit of 15,000 for a 5 month period. Means in the first year of business, there was a 5 month overlapping of profit. And now is planning to change his date to 28th of Feb 2022. So from the previous, if you count, our year end is 31st October. So the previous tax year, we have to identify what was the previous tax year. Now, and actual and budgeted tax adjusted trading profit is given. Year ended 31st October 2020, the previous tax year. Profit per month is 4,500 and profit for the period is 54,000. And now the second date, which is the change date. Now we are changing from October 2020 to 16 months ended 28 Feb 2022. Now from October 2020 to 28 Feb 2022, there is, if you count exactly, there is 16 months time frame, and per month profit is this one, and 16 months profit is 94,000. And then subsequently, we have next 12 month and next 12 month subsequently. Now we have to follow first requirement that P changes his accounting date to 28 Feb. State the date by which he should notify HM Revenue and Custom, one mark for the change of the notification date, and then calculate the taxable trading profit for each of the tax year 21-22 and 22-23. So let's discuss this scenario. First of all, what is the date of change? We have to identify the date of change. 1 minute. Just wait. Now see, the change of date is 28th of Feb 2022. So it means that change of date is 28th Feb 2022. New date. So the tax year for this 2022 is 21-22. And after that, the 31st January will be 31st January 2023. So this is the date which you have to notify HMRC. This is the notification date. One mark for identification of this date. So it's quite simple. You should know the rule that in whatever tax year you are changing the date, you have to identify the next 31st January afterwards. Now the relevant basis period for the tax year 21. Tax year 22. So let's identify. Now see, for the tax year 21-22, the date is 28th Feb 2022, which is 21-22. So profit available is, how much is the profit for the 16 months? Is 94,000. So 16 months profit is 94,000 in the tax year 2022. But we know that a tax year cannot exceed 12 months. A tax year can never be more than 12 months. So what you have to do, we have to deduct the overlapping of profit, that is 4 months in order to make it a 12-month tax year. We have already overlapping of profit, and that was 15,000 for a 5-month period. So if 15,000 overlapping is for 5 months, how much for the 4 months? So that would be 12,000. And we have the assessable profit in tax year 21-22 is 82,000. So what is the benefit of preparing a 20 at Feb 2022 date? The benefit is that as a result of this date, the benefit is that I get some relief of overlap earlier. Whatever is the profit that I have paid twice, that is 15,000 for a 5-month period, the 4-month profit has been realized. Now in the subsequent period, in the next tax year, which is 22-23, that would be 12 months profit. It will be normal now. And what is the 12-month date? That is 88,000. So whenever you have to choose a new accounting date, you have to check that if it is of 12 months, then use that 12 month. If it is more than 12 months, you will get a chance to release your overlap profit. If it is less than 12 months, then there will be additional overlapping of profit. So there will be two situations. One is relief of overlap profit. And the second situation that you might create some further overlap of profit. It depends on the date. So in this way, the date before 5th April is always beneficial because it will result in some relief of overlap profit. It will not create some further overlap of profit. But in the same example, the second situation is, if instead of 28 Feb 2022, we are trying to change the date to 30th April 2022, what would be the basis period for tax year 21-22 and 22-23? And what would be the effect on overlap profit? Now, just 1 month, if you change this just 1 month ahead, then there will be a difference. Now see, before change of accounting date, my year end was 31st October 2020. It means up to 31st October 2020, the profit is already taxed. That is 54,000 in the tax year 2021. Now let's start from this second part. Change of date is 30th April 22 rather than 28th of Feb 22. Now, what was my previous profit? The previous profit is up to 31st October 2020. And profit was 12 months profit was 54,000. So it is already assessed in tax year 2021. A tax is already paid on 54,000 profit. Now the examiner is asking about that in 21-22, what is the profit? And in 22-23, what is the profit? So if we are changing our date from 31st October to 30th April 2022. So see, the next tax year is always of 12 months. So if we choose 30th April 2022, that means the tax year would be 22-23. But after 2021, there will be a tax year 21-22. So we have to set the new date in the next tax year, that is 30th April 2021. So after 31st October 2022, we have to set new date to 30th April 2021. And that is November, December, Jan, Feb, March, April, only 6 months. So if this is the case of 6 months, this is only 6 months. So it means that I'm making a new date to 6 months. But a tax year can never be less than 12 months. It means that for tax purpose, my date up to 30th April 2021 is from 1st May 2022, 30th April 2021. And that will create some further overlapping of 6 months. Because I have already paid tax in the previous tax year. And now there will be some further overlapping of 6 months. So it means 54,000 into 6 by 12, I have to pay tax twice. Already there is a 5 month overlapping, which is 15,000. If I choose a date of 30th April rather than 28th of Feb, this will create 27,000 overlapping. And as a result, total overlapping will be now 15,000 plus 27,000 is equal to 42,000. So clearly, this date is not advisable as this is creating a further overlapping profit. And the previous date was advisable because it was releasing my overlapping profit of 4 months. But as examiner said that identify tax year for 21-22 and 22-23. So my date would be, first one would be 30th April 21. Making a tax year of 21-22. And the next is 30th April 22, making a tax year of 22-23. And we have to assess profit accordingly. So this was a brief discussion about the overlapping basis period and change of accounting profit. Obviously, in just 1 hour, we are not able to cover the entire topic, but I just tried to have a revision of the change of accounting date, the basic basis period concept that must be very much clear before moving to change of accounting date. And then you have to refer to my lecture for change of accounting date, that how you can identify overlapping of profit, how you can identify a suitable change of accounting date, what are the conditions, and so on.